Good evening, everyone. We have a couple of announcements today we want to make.
Thank you.
Terry wants the new members, and then we'll hang on. Right, so you guys know what we're gonna do. Lots and lots of volunteer hours, but we really appreciate it, the whole city appreciates it. So if everyone from the arts council, could please come on up. Alright, thank you so much. Okay, everyone, please go back up. I forgot. We also have a donation for the arts council tonight. I forgot we were getting that. Do you want to take another photograph? The Art League is donating. The Long Beach Art. Yeah, what's the league? Art League. The Long Beach Art League is donating $300 to the arts council. So please come on up. Here, you want to announce the folks about?
I'd like to introduce the president of the Long Beach Art League, Shoshana Finley, and the vice president, Jackie Hill.
We do have one proclamation tonight also, so I would ask Councilwoman to walk and take the mic.
Good evening. Thank you, President Aramo. And tonight, you may recall, this is our final meeting where we celebrate Black History Month. And so once again, on behalf of the city, on behalf of the city council and our acting city manager, we hope that you'll join us in celebrating with respect to a wonderful young man who's a member of the community. And a part of Black History Month is all about passing on and creating legacy. And so this year at the council, we decided that we really wanted to highlight the contributions of our young people. And so youth are our future. And so tonight we're going to ask Brian Horn to come forward and receive a proclamation.
Good evening and welcome to the regular meeting of the Council of the City of Long Beach on Tuesday, February 20th, 2018, at 7 p.m. On the roll call, Councilmember Bendo.
Here.
Councilmember Mandel is absent. Councilmember Moore.
Here.
Vice President Cronin.
Here.
President Ramos. At the recommended presence of Acting City Manager Michael Pesci, Assistant Corporation Counsel Greg Johnson, and Madam City Clerk.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
All right, once again, welcome and thank you for coming out this evening. I would ask that the Acting City Manager please give us the Acting City Manager update.
Okay, as Ms. Moore has stated, this is Black History Month, and the city is proud to celebrate Black History Month, honoring the legacy and contributions African Americans have made to our society and the local home community. To this end, we've been hosting a series of special events all month long at Bridgeworks, the library, the MLK Center, and on Thursday, this Thursday, at Temple Emmanuel, there will be this Friday, there will be a gospel Shabbat at Temple Emmanuel where the Nehemiah Project will perform. And that day I heard them for the first time on Martin Luther King Day, and they are an amazing group, and one of them is actually sitting on the council. Last week, New York State held a meeting on offshore drilling. The U.S. Department of the Interior, Bureau of Ocean Energy Management has recently proposed permitting offshore oil and gas drilling off the Atlantic and Pacific coast, including New York. On behalf of the city, I went to the Suffolk County Legislature last Wednesday to speak with state representatives and provide testimony to the Department of the Interior that the city stands in opposition to this proposal as we put our environment and economy at risk. If anyone who's been riding around the area knows that winter is pothole season. I was been away quite a bit this weekend, you know, all over the island, and the potholes are horrible. We have done a tremendous job in Long Beach. We are doing temporary patching. It was initiated during the winter months, and we have a new plan for the summer months where we do a hot targeting, and it really makes it much, much more effective, and we're actually seeing the fruits of the last couple of years' labor, because we have so many less potholes. The city is now accepting applications for the 2018 Summer Special Program. Applications may be obtained from the Traffic Division of the Long Beach Police Department and call 705-7309 for more information. We are still in the throes of the Village Clerk and Transit Association Food Drive. The Office of the Clerk of the City of Long Beach is participating in the Island Farms Food Drive. The city will be accepting donations through Wednesday, March 8th, with the city clerk on the third floor of City Hall, or to make it even more convenient, we put a collection basket in the entrance to the lobby. In addition to the great accomplishments of Brian Horn, we want to congratulate the many successful Long Beach High School athletes who have been victorious in recent weeks. On February 11th, the Long Beach Square School Boys Swim Team won the Nassau County Swimming and Diving Championships. County title for the 200 relay went to Ryan Presti, Aiden Kennedy, Griffin Kimmel, and Troy Morris, and they also qualified for the state championship. Shikori Kima is a great wrestler in our town, and he captured his fifth Nassau County wrestling title. Remember, you're only in the high school for 4 years, and he's got his fifth title. And he came up as a junior high or middle school student to wrestle on the varsity team. Elijah Rodriguez won his second county wrestling title as well, and Long Beach is duly known for its stupendous wrestling program. We have some little kid in the making that's going to make us proud in a few years. And last Thursday at the Long Beach Ice Arena, the Long Beach High School team again won the Nassau County Championships. They will be going to the States March 2nd, 3rd, and 4th in beautiful Jamestown, New York. If you can get away, you can definitely go. That's my report.
President Ramos, back to just before we go to the program, I just wanted to take an opportunity to wish a very happy birthday to our CSCA president, John Mooney, whose birthday is today. I think he's here, but in case he's watching, a very happy birthday to him. I hope he enjoys the night out tonight.
Yes. All right. Mr. Frazier?
Our first item this evening is a public hearing for resolution granting waiver of Orchard Park requirements for premise 1048 West Peach Street for Acai Bowl Coffee and Smoothie Shop.
Is the owner of the business here? Please come on up. Please state your name and address for the record.
James Luzzi, 99 Michigan Street, Long Beach.
What, 1048, what is that between? That's Georgia?
Between the barber shop and the tattoo bar.
Oh, okay. Right, okay, so Florida and Connecticut.
Florida and Georgia.
Florida and Georgia.
Right.
How many employees do you think you'll have?
I'll probably have between 5 and 7, including myself.
Including yourself. Mostly from Long Beach residents, you hope?
100%.
100%, awesome. Hours of operation?
5:30 to 5:30.
5:30 to 5:30. Will there be deliveries?
Probably not immediately. Probably once they get up and running, I'm going to try to do a delivery service for sure. But that's the issue being that, you know, coffee and an ice cream as opposed to your has to be timely, so
right.
That's an issue.
I'm thinking more deliveries to your shop, like, you know,
oh,
a truck in front of your establishment, blocking traffic for a while. So we would ask that those deliveries be done on off hours, or even park right on Georgia, like most of the restaurants right around there do, so they're not blocking Beach Street. And then going forward, are you willing to supply, install, and maintain a bike rack?
Of course.
So after, let me see, we got a new protocol now. After your building inspection, they will work with you to approve place for a bike rack. So they will be asking you again once the inspection is done. So this way we don't clog up the sidewalks, but those that want, you know, we want to encourage everyone to try and use bicycles, especially in West End.
Sure. I'll also have a bench on the other side of the front porch.
Also have on
a bench sitting there.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. All right. Anyone else on the council have any questions?
Thanks,
that's it. Anyone from the public have any questions? Yeah, we have one question. You state your name and address for the record.
Allison Lynch at Long Beach.
Thank you.
I couldn't hear from the back. This is on by Georgia.
Yeah, between Georgia and Florida, I think it was Jill Insurance Agency is where it was. So
okay.
It's like, you know, just west of the Indian front.
Okay. Oh, yeah. So my immediate concern right here, Georgia, is that is the size of Virginia. Those are the two hotspots for crashes. And so with the playground right over there, and I'm assuming you're probably going to get like a young-ish, well, mixed ages, but you might get a lot of young kids, families, whatever, going over. So I'm a little concerned that when you give a parking waiver to a business that doesn't have any kind of set parking spaces or whatever, you're gonna have people cruising for parking, you're gonna have your delivery people and your vendor vendors circling, looking for parking or double parking. That's a safety hazard, and that's really a problem on the problem. So I just want you to be mindful of that before voting on this. And also I would like to ask a little bit of questions on not just short-term parking for customers, but long-term parking for employees. Is that considered? And is this building, this business going to be ADA compliant? That's a big thing as well.
That's not in the purview of our, that's going to be for the building department to make sure that he's compliant from all.
Okay, would you mind, I don't know if this is taking up his time or whatever, but just for this and for any future ones coming up on the agenda tonight, is that something that the business and the building department that they sort out before getting to this process?
I believe so, but I think they get a final inspection before they open, but I'm not 100%.
Okay, and that's up.
Scott Kemmons is the building department commissioner.
Okay.
Well, I think he's standing in the back.
I'll grab him and ask about the ADA compliance. And then in addition to asking that this business owner consider short and long-term parking for bikes, you mentioned about vendor deliveries being during like off hours.
Mm-hmm.
That's really vague. What is off hours? there, Brett, would you know?
I would know.
Okay, and I don't...
Generally, all the deliveries, that's right where I live, generally all the deliveries happen on Connecticut or Georgia, and they carry their wares over to the different... There's a lot of restaurants right around there. So generally, it's not, each street is not clogged up, and I would think...
Okay, you know, again, right.
Instruct your delivery drivers to not block each street, there's only two lanes.
Okay, I just want to make you all mindful that this isn't just about parking spaces, but this is about curbside management, and this is all about safety that comes in with these kinds of businesses bringing in more foot traffic. Okay. Oh, and one more thing, I'd like to ask the business owner or you guys, whatever. This is over by a bus stop, I do believe, and if maybe this person could also encourage workers and customers to take the bus, maybe sponsor the bus stop, put a bus schedule in the window, that type of thing. So we're not just bringing new businesses.
Unfortunately, he didn't say 100% of the employees are going to be Long Beach residents, so I'm sure they're acutely aware of how parking the situation in the West End.
Sure, but not all the customers.
Right. Thanks. Thank you. Anybody else?
President Aramo, I just want to speak to the customers in reading the application. The owner really emphasized the fact that he's trying to promote a healthy lifestyle with respect to all the individual customers who will be a part of this experience. So I think that particular answer to that question is of concern.
Thank you, Councilwoman. Seeing no one else, I'll close that hearing and call the next one.
Our second public hearing is for a resolution granting waiver of Wall Street parking requirements for premise 62 West Park Avenue for a psychic reading shop.
Okay, could the owner of the establishment please come on? Can you just state your name and address for the record? And then the nature of the business? Okay. And the hours of operation?
This task, and
Quinn County swimming pool supply came in at 0.98 cents a gallon, which we have an anticipated savings of $469 based on this new price.
That's cheaper than what we usually purchase at?
Yes, it's 0.087 cheaper, which will translate, because we paid 70,000 gallons roughly, to $469 in savings.
And how many bids did we receive?
Five.
Yeah. Anyone from council have any questions? Seeing none, anyone from the public? I'm sorry, are there any questions from the public? It's the chemicals for the water pollution control. We're bidding, we got five bids, and we're going to award to purchase chemicals to keep our water, to keep the sewage clean. Any questions? Any comments? No? Seeing none? Next item.
Item 4 is a resolution amending resolution number 116 of 17 to correct a typographical error in the account line.
That's exactly what it sounds like. The money was moved out of various lines to fund the city's wastewater treatment plant. Unfortunately, there was a typo in the account it went into. That is a fatal error, so we have to correct that by Council Matic.
As straightforward as it sounds?
Straightforward as it sounds.
Any questions from the council? Any questions or comments from the public? Seeing none, next item.
Item 5 is a resolution authorizing the city manager to purchase various snacks for the city's after school and summer camp program on an as needed basis from the lowest responsible bidders.
Okay, we have an after school program, and we are required to feed children snacks at this program. Our bid expired, so we went out for a new bid, and we have $8,000 left in the line. We spent half the line, so we anticipate breaking even by the time the summer rolls around, at the end of the fiscal year. And again, this is healthy snacks for our children.
Any questions from the council?
So there's $8,000 remaining in the account to be spent?
Yes. There's 98,000 so far, and there's another 8,000 in it.
Okay, so there is no spending limit on the resolution, so I'd like to propose an amendment to put an $8,000 cap on the spend for this.
Isn't the cap what the amount that's listed in the budget? We can't go over what's listed in the budget.
We have to
And we would have to amend the budget in order to go over the amount that's listed. So I just don't know what would be.
It's not necessary.
We're saying that if you want it to be capped at $8,000, or if you can't spend more than $8,000, you can't anyway, because that's what's in the budget.
True, but normally a resolution has a cost.
I
realize. I understand what you're saying, but I'm just saying that normally a resolution says what the jury can
have. We do a lot of as needed. This is a as needed. As of right now, since they ran out of since the bid ran out, they've been, my understanding is they've been going over to Stop and Shop and paying top dollar for snacks for the children. So we needed to rebid this.
I just have a question. So you're asking, you're looking for the $16,000 to remain, or you're just saying for the $8,000?
Well, I'm not sure what it sounds like. It's $8,000 remaining to be spent. So I was just proposing an $8,000 cap on the resolution to be spent because it's for the remainder of the year.
Okay, so does that amendment on the floor then?
Yeah.
Well, on a point of order, I spoke with the department head, and they don't, and purchasing, they don't feel there's either a slight change going over the allowed amount.
Can't go over the allotted amount. There's right. Only $15,000 in the budget. Right. We spent eight. There's only $8,000 left.
We would have to vote.
That's why it's been approved by the acting by our deputy controller. I mean, that's the purpose of that position, is to make sure that we don't go over what's listed in the budget. I mean, are you looking at that?
Any other questions by the council? questions by the public? Okay, seeing none?
I'm sorry, Councilman Aramo, just a quick question. Maybe this would be helpful in terms of having some information about option to renew for the two additional one-year periods with no increase in pricing. Can anyone speak to that portion of the resolution?
Typically, the way these things are structured is if the city would like to continue this contractual relationship, they could do so without bidding by exercising the option to renew, or the city could always rebid it and see if we can get a better deal.
Thank you.
Maximum flexibility.
But if we exercise the option to renew, we have to come back to the council, correct?
No.
We wouldn't have to.
No, it's in the resolution that the city cannot exercise the option
on their own.
Yeah,
but at this amount.
The city manager, yes, at this amount, it's the city manager who would be authorized to exercise that option.
And we would still need to comply with the amount of money that's listed in the budget under this.
Yes, legally, if something is budgeted for a certain amount for after-school snacks, let's say, the city manager and the city are not authorized to exceed that amount without a council resolution. Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you, Councilman Long. Anyone else from the public? Okay, seeing none, next item.
Item 6 is a resolution authorizing publication of the notice of public hearing of an application waiver for fee parking requirements for premise 919 West Beach Street for Bakery Cafe Restaurant. This item is a publication only, and the hearing will be held on 6 at 7 p.m. Item 1 is a resolution granting waiver of all fee parking requirements for premise 1048 West Beach Street for Acai Bowl Coffee and Smoothie Shop.
You should move the adoption of this item.
I will.
I will. Okay.
I have never had an acai bowl, so I'm looking forward to it.
Yes.
Yes. Congratulations.
Vice President Todd?
Yes.
And President Arnold?
Yes, I look forward to stopping down. I live right there in the West End, so my vote is yes.
Item 2 is a resolution granting waiver of all street parking requirements for premise 62 West Park Avenue for a psychic reading shop.
Would you just move the adoption of this item?
I will.
Okay.
I will.
Okay.
Okay.
Yes.
No.
Yes.
Yes, and good luck.
Okay. Item 3 is a resolution authorizing the city manager to enter a contract to purchase sodium hypochlorite for all responsible bidders.
Would you just move the adoption of this item?
I will.
Second?
I will.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Item 4 is a resolution amending resolution number 116 of 17 to correct the typographical error of the count.
Would you just move the adoption of this item?
I will.
Yes. 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 Item 5 is a resolution authorizing the city manager to purchase various snacks for the city's after school and summer camp programs on an as needed basis from the lowest responsible bidders.
Would you just move the adoption of this item?
I will. This item, we as a council had a conversation about the kinds of snacks that are being offered, and I'm pleased. Maybe the children won't be, but there are brown rice cakes and yogurt and all kinds of really good whole grain things, and I think that's what this is about. It's about promoting a healthy lifestyle for our young people. With that, I vote yes.
Yes,
and I'll just echo what Councilwoman Moore said. I was happy to see on the extensive list of possible snacks are some really healthy options for our students. So thank you for ensuring that those things are in this list, and I vote yes.
Finally, item 6 is a resolution authorizing publication of notice of public hearing of an application waiver for street parking requirements, premise 919 West Beach Street, for a bakery, cafe, and restaurant.
Would you just move the adoption of this item?
I will.
Second?
I will.
All right, Councilman Fender.
Yes.
Councilman Moore.
Yes.
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 I will.
Second?
I will.
Voting, President Fender.
Yes.
President Moore.
Yes.
Vice President Fender.
Yes.
President Rob.
Yes. Okay, we enter our good welfare portion of the meeting. As you know, you get 3 minutes of uninterrupted time. We'll answer questions if we can. And last week we had a question about our social media policy, and I just wanted to let everyone know that it is in fact posted on our social media. If you are interested in our social media policy, it is posted on our Facebook page. First up, Mr. Kevin Riley. Good evening, just state your name and address for the record.
Kevin Riley, Long Beach, New York. I think we can all agree that the city needs a plan for the future. And the 2018 comprehensive plan is supposed to be the roadmap for the future. The plan is supposed to create a blueprint to update our zoning laws while being a guide into the future created by the residents for the residents. But I'm afraid that the comprehensive plan as it stands today only leaves the groundwork for overdevelopment as it sets in motion steps to change Long Beach from a working-class coastal town into a city intentionally overpopulated simply to create more tax base. There is no question that our central business district offers few incentives to stroll down Park Avenue after dinner, and there's also major parking issues in the city. There is no question that there are housing issues that need to be addressed, and sea level rise and coastal flooding need to be dealt with. Unfortunately, this plan looks to fix these things by increasing the population density of the city of Long Beach, or as the comprehensive plan calls it, increasing the tax base. How many times has this room been packed with residents fighting to stop the overdevelopment of Long Beach? From iStar, from the splitting up houses in West End and West Home, to creating two-family houses in East Adams. The people show up and they oppose any overdevelopment of Long Beach in any form. They show up because they want to preserve the city that so many of us cherish. This city has problems and is ready for an update to make this community even more special. But we need to fix our problems by embracing the tradition of Long Beach and its neighborhoods, not by trading a walkable downtown and better parking for 8- and 9-story buildings along the Bayfront. I don't believe this vision is the vision of the people of Long Beach, and I'm positive that you won't find very many people who are willing to add more residents to fix things here. This comprehensive plan is nothing more than a sleight of hand trick. But we're all distracted by the promise of a shiny new amphitheater along the boardwalk or a re-envisioned city hall, maybe fine dining along the Bayfront. Some developer is standing in front of the Nassau County IDA saying, my new mega residential tower provides everything the people of Long Beach said that they wanted in the 2018 comprehensive plan. The buildings will be green, they'll be storm resistant, they'll have parking. They'll even set aside housing for low to moderate income. It's everything the 2018 comprehensive plan wants. How do you fight that? We won't have a leg to stand on when the IDA comes back. And when the Nassau County IDA comes to Long Beach, we all lose. You need to scrap this plan in favor of a plan that returns Long Beach to the people and not to the dollars. Thank you.
Thank you. This is Allison Blanchett.
That would be absolutely wonderful. The other thing I wanted to say is I had sent to you a little while back a rough draft of an amendment. I'm trying to get it. It was a draft of an amendment to municipal code that would put bike parking in with regular vehicle parking so that it would be an actual requirement. So when people come up for parking waivers, parking is not just motorized vehicles, it's also bicycles. They do this, they've been doing this in Cambridge, Massachusetts for years. They do this in New York City. Businesses and dwellings, they're required to have bicycle parking. And I know this because my father-in-law is, I'm not gonna tell you where it works, but let's just say that Rockefeller Center had to deal with all of their, you know, parking structures and retrofit them for bicycle parking. So this is being done in a lot of places. This would actually, I'm being a little selfish here because I'm really just tired of coming up here and asking short-term, long-term parking. Can we just consider putting this in the municipal code? I can resend you the draft that I wrote. I believe I sent it. Anthony, you might have gotten it. Scott definitely got it. I feel like it was about 2 years ago, and Jack said he looked at it, and like everything else, he just never did. So I'm wondering if we can revisit that. I am not going to actually send it to you. I'm going to wait for one of you to respond to me, and I'll send it to you. And I'd be willing to do this, you know, through Long Island Streets. We'll do the work, you know, for the city on this. In addition to adding bicycle parking, when you say, I'll finish this thought, when you say the building people will meet up with business owners to figure out the bike rack stuff, we should already have that made available for businesses such as, finishing my sentence, such as New York City does, Cambridge, Massachusetts. Most cities have bicycle parking, the requirements and measurements in, so there's no reason why we don't have that. That's it. I'll wait for one of you or Scott to contact me. Okay.
Thank you. Ms. Mindy Detmer.
Every single one of you, who the most beautiful man and the most beautiful woman is, you guys are giving me a different answer. Because beauty is in the eye of the beholder, and those beaches are not going to be compromised, their beauty, because of the map on the beach. And that's all I have to say to you guys.
I think I probably speak for this council and the administration when we say we do want the beaches to be accessed by everybody. We do. We want a solution that works for everybody. And I apologize if there seemed to be any sort of misunderstanding or lack of compassion, because that's not. So Mr. Miranda was speaking more from a technical term, just not that they look terrible or anything like that. But speaking to the guys that rake the beach, I'm just trying to explain where he's coming from, that's all. You can't lift them up and rake and stuff, so that's only the issue that he was talking about.
Mr. Mom, all I'm saying is, whether it's a will...
I understand. I completely understand.
...all over the world that have them, and they have found a way.
Right.
He finds a way.
I agree.
His son said last May that as Long Beach comes ADA compliant, this is the way to become...
I wasn't trying to be confrontational. I was just trying to explain where I think he was coming from.
That's
thank you for continuing to come up here and to make, keep us, hold us accountable and make sure the beaches are accessible for everyone.
Just a quick thing, Commissioner Orlando did a draft for the summer plan for Moby Mass, along with increasing handicap parking spaces where the dedicated ramps are, rolling ramps up. He has a coordination going between the lifeguards and the beach maintenance, where at the end of the day, the lifeguards will roll up the mats in the morning. Beach maintenance would roll them out so that it would mitigate the surf cleaning, and it really was a well thought out plan. So he took your concerns very seriously. He is an engineer, he tends to speak very directly to issues, but I think he really understood your plight and the plight of those similarly affected, and he has come up with, I think, a very reasonable solution, and a very equitable solution, and a workable solution.
Awesome. That's nice. That's great news. Ms. Dina Fiore.
Good evening, Dina Fiore, Long Beach. Just want to bring it up.
Thank you.
Since the topic of council came up this evening with the new swearing in, and as you most of you probably know, whether you were sitting on the dais or sitting in the gallery here, where are we going with our website and the information that's posted as it pertains to boards and commissions and the information being updated? It's over a year. I sat down with Jack in November of 2016. I asked the same question through 2017, November. It is almost March of 2018. And I don't understand why it takes we have a problem in getting our website updated with the right information. Not only that, the right names of council members on those boards. It was pretty embarrassing if somebody was to go and seek out somebody on the ethics board or a landmarks association or any of these commissions where we have people listed. I don't know, commissioner, sorry, you're listed as the Humane Society commissioner. I don't know if you're even aware of it.
No, I did. That was one of my, when I first came into this position, we had a terrible issue at the animal shelter, so I did actually take over that position to write the animal shelter. But now, there's no need for me to be in that position.
No, I'm not saying that you should be in the position. I'm saying, are you in the position? And according to our city information, I don't know who manages it, but I got to think it's pretty easy to update our website. And whether it's the ethics board or any one of the 10 or 15 boards that are there. And on top of it, I will go back to the fact that there are people that are willing to participate on those boards and commissions in an unpaid, voluntary position who could bring great things for those areas to you as members. We have an architectural review board that I understand they need. They're approving land, you approved landmarking a house, but you didn't consult. I don't believe people that are like the Historical Society to ask their opinion. There's nobody from the Long Beach Historical Society on the Landmarks Commission. I think that would be a good group to have as part of it. I'm only using it as a comment. We took a lot of time today, again, swearing new people and making a council for the arts. That's great. There are boards and commissions out here that could do a lot more. And I think that it's time now, almost a year and a half later, that information is, at the very least, updated. because I think Doggett is still on the architectural review board. There's people still on that board, and Torres, better not. And so I think it's an embarrassing situation for us to be presenting ourselves out to the public.
Thank you. We'll make sure that's updated, and I'm assuming the next city manager will start filling those boards. As you know, Ms. Fiore, we didn't get as many times as we advertised. I know for the rec board, we only received two resumes. So I know that was part of the issue, but maybe we'll have better luck this time, and I will make sure as a council that the next city manager will, in fact, make that a priority.
I beg to disagree with you, because people copy me on what they sent for positions that they applied, okay, and never got responses for them.
Okay, sure. So I
think also, when you post a position or looking for people to fill out an application,
right,
to apply, they should be responded to.
Correct.
We filled the position, we're interested, we're not interested, thank you for your offer. But I was copied on a number of emails. So to say
should
that people are not,
to
say that people are not interested or not sending information, it goes back to, if we're not drawing people to become part of this, then we have a problem as a city in communicating to the residents to become involved, number one. And number two, if they're not becoming involved, it's because things like this happen. They don't get answered, so why bother?
Right. Point well taken, thank you. Ms. Nori Egan. State your name for the record.
Nori Egan. At the last city council meeting, I streamed the meeting because the commanding officers weren't here. And I was really horrified, Mr. Romo, of your treatment towards Allison Blanchett. I found it very rude and condescending. And I was also horrified that there was other people sitting up here and knew if he took you to task. At most of the good and welfare meetings, you preface it with behavior decorum, and I don't feel like you did. And I feel like you owe Ms. Blanchett an apology. And I think she may have left, but I really would like if you would publicly or privately apologize to her, and not to speak to people like that in the future.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. Scott Kelly. Please state your name and address for the record.
Scott Kelly, we'll reach you here. Sure. Do you have any time frame for hiring the city manager right now?
We don't.
No time frame at all. So basically, you just left wondering what's going to happen.
Well, we're in the process of scheduling interviews. We passed on. And we're going to continue to go through the applications that we received.
Okay. All right. That's it this evening. Thank everyone for coming. Appreciate your input, and please get home safely.